Controversy has long surrounded Britain's biggest women's prison. Inmates being confined to their cells for up to 23 hours a day, staff shortages and cases of self-mutilation by prisoners in the psychiatric unit were just some of the complaints. Last July, a special Home Office report paved the way for change, acknowledging the restrictive regime was having a severe effect. Recommendations included building a new psychiatric unit, allowing more freedom of movement for the prisoners, reviews of staff and the prison population, and providing new accommodation for the prison's mother and baby unit. Ideas only partially introduced, and now the National Association for the Care and Resettlement of Offenders claim that conditions aren't any better.
Things are just as bad. In fact, they may even be worse. Most women at Holloway are locked up in their cells between 21 and 23 hours a day. One particular unit, the unit that gave rise to the whole report and its recommendations, C1 unit for mentally disturbed women, was condemned as totally unsuitable by the report and is still in existence.
For those who've been incarcerated in Holloway, the memories are bitter, particularly when recalling that notorious C1 unit.
Half the time you can hear the girls shouting whilst you're sleeping and you can't sleep at all.
So does that add to the tension within the prison?
Yeah, it does. Had so a lot of tension because, like, the girls would wake up in the morning and complain about it, and there's nothing they can do.
But the view of Holloway from the Home Office is a brighter one, a picture of improvement and change, albeit slowly.
It's no good trying to redesign an existing unit or to build a new one without taking the very possible, best possible care to ensure that what you're doing is going to lead to an improvement in regimes and also an improvement in working conditions for staff.
Marcus Powell at Holloway for Thames News.